another cousin.
Are you are too?
Hello, how are you?
Hi, how are you, Tamara? Nice to meet you.
Hi,
how are you, Carol? Nice to meet you. Oh, sir, nice to meet you.
Yes, it is.
Shepherd, yeah.
in our shepherd.
Saint Paul tells us this.
if we have been baptized in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, we are grafted on Christ in a unique and unendable way to be a part of his body, and yet to understand God's great love and his mercy, and truly what Jesus seeks from us. Because we add nothing to God's glory by our life. Everything God has, he has given to us. But do we truly understand that? Because it's hard to fathom the way we think with our human mind. But God makes his promise. Belief in Jesus, and we can live with him for eternity. To be united together. To be the family of God. To know love, because love never dies. They can't, as love is the very nature of God. So it will endure forever, perfectly. And to show that love in the world is what we are called to do. And as we say goodbye to our friend Charles, a brother, so good to see the extension show up. We've lost two members of that society who seek to be God's love in the world. Because not long ago, we were laying many of our spirits to rest. And, well, ever since I've been here, Charles and Kathleen have been faithful extension, helping to give people what they need to get through life, to understand that what we receive is meant for the good of others. I remember my first impression of Christ, because when I first gave him Holy Communion, he always said the same thing. Amen. Thanks be to God. And sorrow came from something. Oh, extra words. I'm not used to hearing that. But it was his thanksgiving to receive Jesus in the sacrament. And it made an impression on me. And anyone who knows it knows. He was a very soft-spoken and gentle man. Maybe the family knows him a bit differently, but at least here in the church. He always said something when he felt he needed to talk. Reminded me a lot of what they say about St. Joseph. But he always was there. Always supported. And I know, as his illness was taking him down, he wasn't always so happy. Because he wanted to do more. He didn't want to just stay in his chair and take his medication. He still wanted to go out. And a couple of times when I got the privilege to visit him there, he would tell me this. And yet, he still knew life was worth living. And so we talked about that sacrifice of Jesus and his part in that sacrifice, to humbly submit to the will of God and to leave all things in God's hand. And I believe that's what he tried to do. Life was probably never perfect. I know he knew struggle. I know he knew hard work. And I know he knew what to do with a piece of food. Right? And as I was putting my vestments on, I don't remember who it was, but Vic was talking to one of the family members, and they mentioned goat head soup. What is that? property you would like. But I didn't know that before today, in fact, this morning. But we're so amazing in our lives. And I give God thanks for each and every one of us. Because his life was unique and his journey was his own. But in Houston, he gave his life to Jesus. I don't think he ever looked back. From the moment he was baptized, he was, to me, the one who was strong and silent, who did what needed to be done, who spoke very rarely, but almost always, in praise of what God has done for his life. And this is the example of the one who walks today. So, as we continue our prayer for him, that the Lord may open the gates of heaven to him and receive him into that eternal life. Well, we will miss him. But if we strive to be more like him, remember to give thanks to God. And to unite our sufferings to Jesus' own. Well, then the possibilities are endless. Because of God, nothing is impossible. And we will be together again when Jesus decides. Lord Father, give up my daydream. But I know we will be together forever. And the love we have for each other, again, is still there. It's there for you in Christ, because love never dies. Where he intercedes for his church, confident that God hears the voice of those who trust in the Lord, we join our prayer to his.
In baptism, Charles received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead him over the waters of death. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Our brother Charles was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome him in the halls of heavenly banquet. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Many friends and members of our families have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Many people die by violence, war, and famine each day. Show your mercy to those who suffer so unjustly these sins against your love, and gather them to the eternal kingdom of peace. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Those who trust in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, and peace to all whose faith is known to you alone. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
The family and friends of Charles seek comfort and consolation. Heal their pain and dispel the darkness and doubt that come from grief. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer. Sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the present good of his name, for our good and good of his holy church.
As we humbly present to these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Charles, we beseech your mercy, that he who did not doubt your son to be a loving Savior may find him in a merciful judge, who lives forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation. Always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. Amen. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life has changed, not ended. And when this early dwelling place turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
The glory, Hosanna in the highest. Salvation comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
May holy, therefore, these gifts we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when the supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Amen.
As the Savior's command informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and healing, in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Peace be with you. Thank you. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Take away sins of the world. Enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
has strengthened by it. Our brother Charles may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
So I ask you to be seated. I believe one of the
members. And that, hopefully I'm saying correctly, was born on June 14, 1931, in Darlington, Westmoreland, Jamaica. He was the first child of his mother, the late Clementina. Excuse me. Charles and his mother moved to Portland when he was 5 years old. His biological father was absent throughout his lifetime. Charles commenced his formative education at Sherwood Forest All-Age School in January 1947. Growing up was difficult, as a single mother alone could not provide his basic needs of food, clothing, and shelter. Therefore, Charles was informally adopted by Mr. Vernal Harris and Mrs. Miseria Harris, residents of Sherwood Forest. Life for Charles became much better in many ways, as his now adopted parents had a stable family setting and could afford to provide his basic needs. In his late teens, he moved to Kingston, Jamaica, to learn a skill to seek employment. Charles realized his calling was employed for many years as a master chef by Pegasus in Kingston. During his time at Pegasus, he earned many awards and was considered to be one of the top chefs in that hotel chain until he left that post. Charles decided to apply his skills overseas and migrated to the United States. He joined Carnival Cruise Line, where he worked as a chef for some years. He was later recruited by Nassau Bay Hilton in Houston, Texas. He later moved to Florida, where he was employed by the Ocean Reef Club. Charles returned to Texas, where he worked as a chef at the Westminster Retirement Home in Austin, Texas. Charles received numerous awards in recognition and appreciation for his sterling contribution and application of his own skill to these organizations. Charles met the love of his life, Kathleen Pierre, in early 1982, and did not hesitate to establish a lifetime of love, care, and affection. Hence, they were married on July 7, 1984, at the Holy Ghost Catholic Church in Houston, Texas. They have been a model couple of love, kindness, care, dedication, commitment, and honesty ever since. Charles has achieved much through his dedication to work and family life. But his greatest achievement was when he gave his life to the Lord. He was baptized on April 18, 1987, at the Holy Ghost Catholic Church in Houston. Since moving to Gainesville, Florida, Charles and Kathleen have been members of St. Patrick Catholic Church. Charles was preceded in death by Clementine Moore, Vernell Harris, and Miss Sarah Harris, Joyce Gale, and Marilyn Simpson. His loved ones can rest assured he has gone to a better place. Left to mourn his passing is his dear wife, Kathleen, son, Wendell, otherwise known as Johnny, daughter, Marilyn, otherwise also known as Michelle, Tamara, and Katie. Siblings, Patsy, Ruby, Inez, Cindy, and Julie. Grandchildren, nieces, nephew, and other relatives and friends. I'll read a quote from a well-known man. That man is a success who has lived well, loved often, and loved much, who has gained the respect of intelligent men and the love of his children, who has filled his niche and has accomplished his task, who leaves the world better than he found it, who has never lacked appreciation of Earth's beauty or failed to express it, who looked for the best in others and gave the best he had. May his soul rest in peace. And this wonderful quote was written by Robert Lewis. I think I must add that strength is gained, and I have gained strength, and being able to read this effortlessly. And the strength was gained because I also lost my mom 10 months ago. So with doing this, I take great honor to presenting, you know, all the good things about that. And like I said, strength is gained, and I have had enough strength to be here today. So may his soul rest in peace.
Amen.
May our farewell express our affection for him. May he ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself.
Thank you.
Please, can you tell us your name and what you know about Mr. Charles Forrest?
Okay. Well, my name is Kaylin Forrest, and I am the last child of Charles Forrest.
Goodness.
Yes, I'm the baby. About mom and dad. But my dad has always been on the move, always on the go. You know, my dad is always working, cooking, and entertaining and helping others, you know. That's the most I remember about him. And I think we have gotten some of those attributes, you know, because he's always the person who is trying to find the next place to go to work and show his skills as the person he was, you know, a great chef, a great person with his family, you know, amazing in whatever he does. He did it to his best. You know, and that's the part about him that stood out the most as that person. And you know, like the urologist said, he worked so many places, great hotels, beautiful places, because of his great skill. You know, he could embark on those different places. And he will be missed greatly.
Yes, indeed. Well, it's a great pleasure to have you here in Gainesville for the funeral. He was a great friend.
Yeah, he was a great friend.
Yeah. And I didn't realize he was a chef until I went to his house.
He cooks up everything for you.
Yes.
Know? And I think we got that attribute, cooking, you know, always making people feel comfortable and stuff. Yes.
Yeah.
Yes, he will be missed.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Okay. Please, could you tell us your name, your relationship with Mr. Charles Forrest?
Okay, my name is Tamara Forrest. The relation to Charles Forrest is my father.
Wow. Well, we're happy to have you here today in Gainesville, Florida.
Great, thank you.
Thank you. Tell us a little bit about your father.
Well, he's a great cook. A very good cook. Always smiling. Always, you know, jolly, happy. Always cracking jokes about something. Mm-hmm. You ask him a question, it's always a joke. But most importantly, I enjoy his cooking.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Just here in Gainesville, especially this church we are in here, St. Patrick, just belong to several organizations here.
Okay.
And very, very notable. Okay. He comes to church every Sunday here, and, you know, so personally, you know, as a member of the parish myself too,
yes,
I get to know him. He talks a little bit about your place, Jamaica.
Yes.
But you were born here in America, were you?
No, I was born in Jamaica, but we moved here pretty young.
Okay.
Yes.
Yeah, I could see.
I live in New York.
Yeah, I couldn't dictate that accent so far, you know, so that's why I'm asking.
Okay.
Yeah. What would be your prayer for him now?
My prayer?
Yes.
That his soul is resting in peace, and he has peace with God, with himself, with his children, his friends, and his wife.
Amen. Thank you so much.
No problem. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Bye.
Bye.
Please, could you tell us your name and how you come to know Mr. Charles Forrest?
My name is Allison Hannibal, and Uncle Charles was married to my Auntie Mutti, and I met him at their wedding.
Wow. So what do you think about, do you live here in Gainesville?
No, I live in Atlanta.
Oh, you drove all the way from Atlanta here?
Mm-hmm.
Oh my good. Oh yes, you are the one in Atlanta. Miss Kathleen always talk about you and tell me about the people, you know, you guys have, they have in Atlanta.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, finally come to meet you.
Yes.
Yeah. Thank you for coming.
Yes.
Yes. So what is one thing that will ever remain green in your mind concerning Charles?
One, the thing that always I remember is that he likes the goat head soup.
You like the what?
Goat head soup.
Yes.
So that was always something funny because I don't know anything about goat head soup. And he used to go to the farmer's market looking for a goat head to make this soup. So that's something that I always remember because I don't know anybody else.
Yes.
I guess it's a Jamaican thing, but I don't know anybody else who liked the goat head soup.
It's not only Jamaican thing. It's African thing.
Okay, okay.
Because I have African store. And I have goat head in the freezer. So he used to come and buy it.
Yes.
And make a pepper soup.
I guess so.
Pepper soup. Yes.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't realize he was a chef.
Yes.
I did not realize until I went to his house and I saw his picture there with this is when he was sick.
Mm-hmm.
You know. Oh my goodness.
Yes.
Well, it's a pleasure to have you here.
Yes.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Bye. Okay, please, could you tell me your names and what is your relationship with Charles Forrest?
My name is Michelle Brooks, and I am the niece of Charles Forrest.
Okay.
And I'm Carell Pierre, and I'm the niece of Charles Forrest.
Yes. What is one thing that stands out in your mind whenever you think about Mr. Forrest?
Mr. Charles, he makes us laugh.
Yeah.
Yes. Such a warm heart, but he always makes sure that we are full of joy and excitement. He's a warm spirit.
Mm-hmm.
And
mm-hmm.
I would say his honesty and bluntness.
Yes.
Told it like it was. Uncle Charles, put it out there. Miss him. He'll be greatly missed.
Yes, absolutely.
Although today is a sad day, and the same token, a happy day that we come to celebrate his life. What would be your prayer for him now?
Well, that he is now comfortable and at peace. And that's something that we always wish for him in these past few weeks. But no more pain and at peace.
Amen.
Ultimate joy.
Yes.
And with all the others that have passed as well. So he's there with them, living it up.
Yes. Thank you so much.
Absolutely. Thank you.
Okay. Bye.
Bye-bye.